just in the new Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross. This is Mitsubishi's entry into the crowded SUV market. On the sort of size of your Karoq, Arona, that sort of size thing, the smaller end of the medium SUV market. This one I'm driving is the InStyle, which is the top of the three specs you can buy. The bottom one starts at about 27 or 28,000 or somewhere around there. This one I'm sitting in is 34.9. That's with the 6-speed manual box. You can also go with a CVT automatic, which is 37,000 odd. It's not big money for cars in this class, and certainly the spec that you get in this car is really quite spectacular. Very good infotainment system, heads-up display, Rockford Fosgate speakers, which make lovely sound when you turn them up. I'm just working my way across mirrors here. You have blind spot detection, heated seats, you have dual zone climate control, which works really well. There's a lovely auto setting on it that really does keep the temperature very stable in the car. On the infotainment system, you have Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, all those bits that are fairly well normal now. Also with this spec, you get lovely, really very comfortable sports leather seats, gorgeous leather steering wheel. On the spec list on this, you get Isofix fittings across the back seat for baby seats. On the styling front, start of the week, picked it up, walked around it a little bit, not so sure. But now that I've spent a few days with it, I think it's quirky looking. It's different. It's not the standard box that is out there in some cars now, that they're all looking a little the same. This one's different. You can see here in the view, you have the line here across the back window. This is a styling feature. It's like an old AP cab, New Holland, or Ford back in the day, had the split across the back window. And the Super Qs afterwards also had the same thing. But it's not an issue. It's just something that causes the strangest little thing to happen at night. I was driving down the road yesterday evening, and as cars get closer to you, the lights disappear behind the little bar and then appear again. So you occasionally go, oh, there's no one behind me, someone behind me, someone behind me, no one behind me. And it can be a little bit, it's not off-putting. After about 3 minutes, you're very used to it. But when it started happening the first time, I thought it was a little odd. Just back to the interior for a second. Mitsubishi have put this very nice little control pad, like a mouse pad, on your phone or on your laptop. Exactly the same thing. Has it down here beside you. It's a very handy way of flicking around the infotainment screen and knowing exactly what you're at. Fairly hassle-free. It's a fairly simple way of doing it. And you don't have to take your hand up and put it onto the touch screen to get through what you need to do. So it's a good little system. I like it. And they have four tactile buttons as well, that you can actually push to get to menus. All in all, this car is, it's really very good. It's very good. This one has the 1.5 petrol engine, 163 brake horsepower. The only slight issue I have is €390 tax, but I'm presuming that later in the year, when the 2.2 diesel version comes online, which I think will be late summer, early autumn, that should sort that problem. But I think that €390 tax isn't so bad. It's a very good little engine. It's gutsy, like it can move this along quickly. As you can see, I'm out on the dual carriageway here now, and it's very quiet, very simple, and the petrol engine is very good for that and there's a fighting chance that the diesel won't be as refined and as nice. But we shall see.